everyone, it's Ali here once again from Tut Gurus. How are you doing today? I hope you're all awesome. I hope you're all safe and well out there. Today, what we're going to be looking at is how to install WordPress on GoDaddy hosting. Now, there's different types of hosting providers out there. There's many to choose from. Some we recommend are SiteGround, WP Engine. There's also GoDaddy. There's different ones depending on your budget, depending on what you really want. Now, I have done other tutorials on SiteGround and other types of hosting, so you can check them out as well. But for this tutorial, let's dive in and have a look on how you can easily set up WordPress on GoDaddy with a few clicks of a button, maybe a few more than the clicks. Check this out. So you want to go to GoDaddy.com, and once you're in there, you want to go to hosting, and inside of hosting, you want to choose, under hosting, you want to choose web hosting. So when you click on that, it takes you to this page here. And when you scroll down here, you'll notice there's some different plans. Now this appears to be picking up Australia. I probably logged in as a client website, but GoDaddy.com. So if it's not on this, it can also be if you scroll to the bottom of the page, you can actually choose which country you want to come from, which actual currency you want to choose, USD. Do you want to have it in which country? You want to have it in, let's say, United States. Let's just do that. Okay, so now all the prices on here will actually be US dollar. Okay, so if you want to change that, you can by scrolling to the bottom of the page and changing it. So the packages they have are different types. They have this one here where you get a standard one website. So if you think you're only going to have one website, then you can use something like this. Just so you're probably aware, once you know how to start building websites and once you really understand what you're going to be doing in this course and in the next courses coming through Tut Gurus, you're probably going to want more than one website. You don't normally just build one website. Once you know how to build websites, you build loads of websites. So you're going to want a higher plan. So unlimited websites is good. This one on this $12.99, this comes with a free SSL. Now, just be aware that this is for the first year, okay? So you get this for the first year. After that, you're gonna be charged. So for example, an SSL certificate is $79 after the first year. These SSL certificates on GoDaddy are actually quite expensive. We can, and we'll do a tutorial soon on showing you how you can buy an SSL certificate from somewhere else for, let's say, $3 to $10, and then just bringing it into your GoDaddy. But for now, if you wanted the first free, you can do that just by choosing this package. So then you would just simply add to cart, choosing the package that you want. It will offer you different choices. Now, GoDaddy are notorious for like upselling. You get the checkout and it's like $1,000. Like, what's going on? So just keep an eye on them. Only take what you want. So 12 months, okay, that brings it back down to 215. But you'll notice here it's got website backup, $35. So let's scroll down and choose no thanks. This is what they do. You just need to make sure that you're only buying what you want, which is the hosting. That's why I'm actually doing stage by stage here. If you haven't got a domain, you can add one. You can come in here, do a search, and it will find a domain for you. It'll let you know if it's available or not. I'm just going to choose no thanks because, you know, I've got one attached to this, so I don't need to actually buy one. And then you come to checkout. So again, make sure that everything in checkout is what you want. Now, you might not want this Microsoft 365 starter. It's free for 12 months, but then afterwards you'd have to pay. I'm just gonna delete out. Again, you can get the free SSL certificate for now, and then I'll show you later on how you can get one a lot cheaper, so that's fine. So you've got a 12-month hosting package, cPanel, with SSL. Now, we normally use Linux hosting. Linux hosting is what we need for working with PHP, stuff like that. They also have Windows hosting. Now, people get confused. They think they're running Windows on their computer and they think they need Windows hosting. You don't need Windows hosting if you're running Windows. All you need is Linux hosting, which will allow you to run Windows on your computer or Mac or Linux on your, whatever you're using. It's not about what you're using as a computer, okay? I have heard that many times, that's all. And then you would choose checkout. You would follow the stages and then you would buy the product. They will send you an email with login details. Once that's done, you then need to come inside, log in, and you wanna go to all products and services section. There'll be a part in here that says web hosting. It'll ask you to set up, just follow it along. Just make sure you don't add the website builder. They include a website builder. It is rubbish. It's absolutely not worth doing anything with. You don't have full customization. You want to be making sure you're working with WordPress here or some other platform if you're using something else. But don't use their built-in website builder. It drives you crazy. And then it will make building websites so complex when it's not. Okay, so just follow those steps. Just set up your web hosting. Once it's set up, it will look something like this, you know, where it'll say cPanel is what you want to be using. You then click on that, you choose manage. Once you come into that, you'll then come to this page, and on this page, you'll be able to log into your cPanel. Just simply click on cPanel. That will take you to the back end of it all. Now, cPanel sounds super scary, but it's not. It's just where all your files, where you can add stuff, manage your emails. You don't need, if you're using cPanel, you don't need to get things like G Suite or other emails because you can actually include them. They're actually built into cPanel. Now, inside of cPanel, it might look like this. It might look different. GoDaddy updates quite often, so the look might be different. But cPanel is pretty much cPanel, has a similar structure. You just need to sort of scroll down and sort of find what we're looking for. So what we're looking for is if you scroll down, you're looking for applications, web applications. And inside of here, we want to actually install WordPress. Going to click on WordPress. Lovely. And inside of here, you just want to come up to the top here. You want to install this application. This application being WordPress. All right. This is actually the same process if you're doing e-commerce, if you're doing like OpenCart, Joomla, these types of things. This is a similar process. I'm going to choose install this application. And once I do that, it will bring me to a section where I can add my domain. Now, depending on how many domains you actually have, if this is a fresh install, you'll probably just see one domain. If you're like me and have multiple, and you just buy domains just for the hell of buying domains, then you might have a lot inside of here. I'm just going to select the drop-down, and I'm just going to choose the one that I want, which is going to be aussiewebagency.com. This was a web agency that we were going to set up, but what we're going to actually do during these future courses, future trainings on Tut Gurus here, is we're actually going to build a web agency, show you how to create a web agency website, start to put it out so you'll actually learn how to get clients as well. That's a future project that's coming. At the moment, we're building it from you knowing nothing about any of this to eventually owning your own web agency and making thousands of dollars. So when it asks for a directory, if this is going to be installed in, for example, aussiewebagency.com, like when they go to aussiewebagency.com, they see this website, then you don't put anything in directory optional, in directory, sorry, as it says, it's optional. If you want this to be inside of a folder, let's say this is an e-commerce website, you want it to be aussiewebagency.com/shop, and then you want everything to do with the shop inside of there, then you would put it in a subfolder. For now, I just want this to be my main website, so I'm going to leave this blank. 5.6, its version is okay. Yep, that's the latest version of WordPress as we're doing this tutorial. Yeah, I accept the language you can choose, but I'm just going to choose English. Anything else I'm not very good at. These things you can just pretty much leave as standard. The next thing you'll come to is this section here. I'm just, because this is a fictitious website and I'm going to delete it as soon as I've done this tutorial, I'm just going to put in any username and password. What I would suggest is that you don't call it admin though, you call it another name, whatever you want to use. Just, I wouldn't suggest using admin. Admin is a very common name that bots and hackers are looking for when trying to hack your website. So just put in a username that you know, that's fine. I'm just going to put in a password. Like I say, I don't really care because this will be deleted by the time you're actually watching this. Down here, just add your email. So I'm going to add, let me do actually Hallie at tutgurus.com. You can put your blog title and your tagline. To be honest, you don't need to worry so much about that. You can do that later. Watch some other tutorials, talks about how you can actually change that. I'll put a link in above here. And we're just going to scroll down. I don't want it in multiple sites. Automatically manage advanced settings for me. And I'm just going to choose install. This is going to go through. As you can see, it's here. It's processing. It's going to go through. It's going to install WordPress onto this particular domain name, onto this website. It's just doing its thing. Doesn't normally take too long, depends on your internet speed. Just halfway now, it's going quite fast. And we are complete. So once you complete, this is what you're displayed with. the name of the website, aussiewebagency.com, the how to log in, and then underneath this is support. It's showing you the version, it's showing you different information. But what we can do is we can actually click on this WP-admin. I'm just going to click on that. It will open in a new tab. And this will take me to the back end of the website. Now, in GoDaddy, because they like to keep adding stuff, then what they'll do is they'll offer you to get a theme. Don't worry about any of this. You don't need to worry. Just choose exit to WordPress dashboard. Are you sure? Yes, I'm sure. Why is the reason? No, thanks. I want to exit. So we just go get rid of all of that because we're going to do that later on in these tutorials. So here it is, a fresh install of WordPress on your domain name. You'll notice here, aussiewebagency.com. This is how we've installed it, which we'll go through in the next few tutorials. We're going to go through each of these sort of stuff. So that is your WordPress install. But for now, we have installed WordPress on our GoDaddy hosting account under our domain. And that allows us now to move forward to these other tutorials. So I hope this has been helpful for you. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel. We'd like to help grow this channel. If you're liking the tutorials, give us one of those thumbs up, or you can leave a comment below. Like, we love comments. Leave a comment below. Let us know where you're at. Do you need any help? Like, this is a community where we don't take the mick out of each other. This is a community where we grow together, okay? We have a Facebook group that you can join should you want to be part of a cool, awesome community. And if you want to be notified when these next tutorials are coming out, just click that bell and we will notify you when I have some more awesome content coming out. Take it easy, guys and girls. I shall catch you all in the next tutorials. Laters.